Good morning. Cat. Let's continue the story, shall we?
My dearest friends, praise be unto the 12 for delivering you from the clutches of treachery.
Father!
Pippin, my son, and Master Papachian besides.
Forgive me, Father. I should have been at Her Grace's side.
Save your tears. The Sultana yet lives.
You.
It was I who arranged this gathering. And judging by your perplexed expressions, it would seem introductions are in order. I am Dulala, head of the Order of Noldthor, and member of the Syndicate.
What you said about the Sultana, is it true? Is she alive?
Young man, I understand you were with the Sultana when she drank from the poisoned goblet and collapsed. Would I be correct in assuming that you did not personally verify Her Grace's vital signs?
No.
Why ask when 'tis plain you know the answer?
Calm yourself, General, and let me finish. The truth is not as you imagine it. You are all victims of a most ingenious ruse. A ruse conceived to eliminate the threat posed by Teleji Adeleji. Tis my belief that Teleji plotted the Sultana's assassination alone, but that Lolorito caught wind of his plot and exploited it to his own ends. He sought to manipulate you into eliminating Teleji for him, and you duly obliged.
It does happen.
At one fell swoop, he removed his two foremost rivals, all the while remaining above suspicion.
The great game at work.
God strike me down for a fool. But the Sultana, how can it be that she lives?
The handmaiden was perhaps not as corrupt as they thought.
She lives because Lolorito willed it. Her own lady-in-waiting is but one of his many little birds. By her sleight of hand, the poison was switched for a less deadly draught before it could reach her mistress's lips.
Some manner of sedative, perchance, of a potency sufficient to induce a slumber like unto death.
Were I to guess, I would say Her Grace is being held somewhere, dreaming dreams of a brighter Uldar, even as we speak.
Oh, Nanamo! I will never forgive Lolorito for his part in this.
Though Lolorito's hands are far from clean, they did pluck Her Grace from the jaws of death. That must count for something.
That's true. He literally saved her life, even though he's plotting, even though he's part of this thing to make everybody look guilty. He did save her life.
And though one may call the man's methods into question, it cannot be denied that he knows the value of stability to
right.
The very gill, like as not. He craves power, 'tis true, but he has no desire to depose the Sultana.
And in fact, she is much more useful to him asleep than awake, because as soon as she wakes up, she's going to dissolve the Sultanate. And so, yeah. He wants her out of the way, but not dead.
I had never taken sides in your feud with the monetarists, but it was not for want of concern for our nation's welfare. Indeed, 'twas out of the desire to see order restored that I furnished your Far Eastern friends
sure
with information and arranged this gathering.
All right.
I hope you are ready to work, General, for there is much work to be done. Our first priority must be to bring matters back into balance. Lest you forget Her Grace's words, the true wealth of Uldar lies in the health, happiness, and hopes of her people.
This is true.
As for the more worldly kind of wealth, I am content to let Lolorito help himself to whatever Teleggi Adeleggi left behind. You, meanwhile, must do that which you alone can do. Rescue Her Grace and take your place at her side once more, for her sake and that of our nation.
So when they find out that she means to abdicate the throne, how is that going to go? And I imagine they're not going to be big fans of that. I've not counted on Prioress Dirwala herself appearing. In my defense, my suspicions regarding the Sultana proved more prescient. Much remains to be done, but in rescuing Ra'ban, we've taken a vital first step toward resolving matters in Uldar. We couldn't have done it without you, Pieta. Thank you. Yeah, I don't think we're quite done. Let's go off, you know. The Taru. Yes, General Ra'ban is now in safe hands. What, another assault? Very well, we shall return at once. Pray, notify the Count of our coming. It would seem we face another crisis. The Dervanians are preparing to resume their siege of the Holy See. And those who abandoned the Sultana to her fate, we lack the necessary evidence to act upon Dawala's claims. That being the case, I propose we leave Marshal Terrapin and the others to investigate, and return with all haste to Ishgard.
Boom. Quest accepted.
Man, Cat just loves this game. That's the wrong way. Let's go to Vespa Bay. Vespa Bay, eh? Siege or not to siege? That's the question. I'm like, how is it too far away? It's right freaking there beside you. Apparently it was after something else. Hello, this is my little dragon friend. Don't mind him. Oh, there you are. Sorry for cutting your reunion with General Ra'ban short. It wouldn't have bothered you, but the city's awash with rumors of another Dervanian attack, and Lord Hoshifan's desperate to get a hold of you. Speaking of whom, he and the others are waiting for you inside, so you'd better head in. Welcome, Master Krolinsk. Shall I show you inside the manor? Yes, let's do that. Can you just nod me on my leg here? Just gently nibbles the leg and is like, okay, Cat, I'm not playing a game right now. Oh, my friend, I thank you for answering our call with such alacrity. As I'm sure you're now aware, the Dravanians are once more gathering for war. Master Krolinsk, Master Levelier, I must apologize for this abrupt summons, but we thought it best to have Mistress Tataru contact you by the most direct means available. While the observatorium's bells toll, 'tis a warning that cannot be ignored. The Holy See has ordered that we make ready for battle. In case you haven't heard, the band of trappers returned to the west, claimed that they saw a cloud of dragons big enough to dim the midday sky. Nighog's minions gather once more for war.
But I would not have you take up arms in another of our conflicts. When first you came to Ishgard, I offered you my protection. If I cannot ensure your safety here, I cannot well accept your aid, much less ask of it. Scions of the Seventh Dawn, you are faced with a choice. To remain in a besieged Ishgard, or seek sanctuary elsewhere. I would not presume to influence your decision, but I ask you to make it swiftly, lest our enemies force your hand.
I choose both.
Though we flee to the end of the world, 'twould seem that no place in this troubled age is free from strife. Once more the Horde descends upon Ishgard, and once more her weary defenders must take up spear or bow. The Count would have us seek shelter in this storm, but I, for one, grow tired of running. If we are to shine the light of dawn, we must do so in sight of our fellow man, not hunkered in a hole. What say you, Pieter?
It would stay here and fight.
Then fight we shall. Never let it be said that we abandon our allies in their hour of need. The choice we make this day shall have grave implications for this order. It is only right that Tataril should have a say. Come, let us all meet outside and discuss the plan that lies before us.
Not a fan of Ross.
Generally, I'm much more of a tank kind of mindset, so being a healer is tough on me.
Ishgard cannot well endure another assault. Even should her knights succeed in turning back the Horde, the casualties will be catastrophic.
Yes.
But what other choice do we have? It's not like we can talk it over with them. Dragons and men aren't exactly on speaking terms.
I actually have a person we could talk to.
With certain notable exceptions.
I've had discussions with dragons.
You don't mean Iceheart?
Well, that is someone you could talk to.
When last you spoke with her, she lamented her crimes, did she not?
Aye.
Then there remains a sliver of hope.
Duh.
If we can persuade Iceheart to act as our intermediary, we may yet be able to convince Nidhogg to abandon his bloody course.
It would be better to talk than fight.
Probably. If there is to be a meeting, I would accompany you.
Estinian?
Alastinian, welcome.
Even with your intermediary, Nidhogg's blood rage may render him deaf to reason. However, the mere attempt may afford our forces precious time to prepare.
He must use this as distraction.
Of course. You might also consider a more direct approach to ending this conflict. With the power of the Eye at my disposal, and the vaunted strength of the Warrior of Light, we could conceivably slay the beast outright.
So, my wife keeps making mention of Estinine being a jerk, so I'm gonna guess this is not gonna go well.
If we are to risk a face-to-face meeting with the Dread Worm, I for one would feel safer in the company of the Azure Dragoon. However, I should only turn to your lance if my words failed to find their mark. Is that clear?
I think he's gonna jump the gun, is what I think.
Perfectly. I shall assume that Iceheart enjoys similar diplomatic protection until instructed otherwise. A word of advice. Think carefully before divulging the particulars of this plan to Sir Emmerich. 'Twould not do to have the Lord Commander accused of consorting with heretics.
Right. This is the heretical action.
Indeed. I thank you for your counsel, Estinian. We shall be honored to have you with us.
So, I can't trust him. And I can't trust me, because I've got a freaking dragon buddy that's spying on us the entire time.
I'm glad to be of service.
Yeah. This is going to go amazingly well.
We've chosen a difficult road. Yet even should we succeed in winning Iceheart to our cause, our plans for parley will swiftly come to naught should the Holy See decide to strike first against the Horde. We must petition the Lord Commander's aid, and we set forth. I only hope that Sir Amaric would be willing to muzzle Ashgard's forces on the strength of our vague assurances. Tatterall, I would ask that you remain at Fortem's Manor and inform the Count of our decision. Tell him the Scions of the Seventh Dawn mean to do all in their powers to ensure that Ishgard and her people survive.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is going to go amazingly well. This is going to be an absolute disaster.
Let's go talk to the zealots and convince them not to attack. Zealots are known for being very easy to talk to and happy to listen.
You'd speak with the Lord Commander? Pray, make it quick.
I want the defenses of the Outer Ward rechecked. See to it that the ballistas are in good repair and supplied with enough ammunition for a prolonged siege.
At once, my lord.
Ah, 'twould seem I have visitors, and unlike those messing beyond our walls, these ones are welcome.
Would that we remain so.
Pray forgive us for interrupting you in the midst of your preparations, Sir Amaric. But our suit concerns the impending assault. To speak plain, we believe there is a chance the invasion might be halted before it even begins. I can divulge little more at this time, but I must nevertheless request that you advise the Holy See to refrain from launching any preemptive sorties whilst we seek to put our plans in motion.
I will gladly lend my support to any endeavor that could spare the blood of my countrymen, but I would know more of the cause you would have me champion.
Yeah, that's
will you not
wise.
Share aught of this mysterious undertaking?
We're gonna talk with the enemy. A heretical action. You're totally down with that, right?
Know that I have offered my lance to aid in this endeavor. I cannot claim that its success is assured. But our actions should serve to delay Nidhogg's advance at the very least. Which is more than can be said for the ill-conceived counterattack advocated by the Sea's more vocal crusaders. They offer glorious death, but little hope of victory.
Yeah. Victory is definitely better than death.
Aye. Their proposal does not inspire confidence. Our resources should rightly be spent shoring up the city's defenses.
Defense is good.
The Azure Dragoon and the Warrior of Light sallying forth together to face the Dread Worm Nidhogg.
Definitely, definitely gonna work. Definitely.
I must admit, the mere thought of it does much to dispel my misgivings. Go then. Carry out your plan. I shall do what I can for you within the Holy See.
Within the congregation of our knights most heavenly. It would be nice to be a holy knight.
Having secured Sir Amaric's support, we may proceed without fear of a preemptive Ishgardian attack, which is not to say we can afford to dither. History tells us that the Dravanians will attack as soon as the horde reaches a critical size. Before that happens, we must needs track down and win over the Lady Iceheart, and then locate and parley with Nidhogg. In short, time is against us. If you're ready, Istanine, let us be about our task.
Oh, look, it's a round table.
Such commotion.
Yes, Your Eminence. The bells of the observatorium warn of our enemy's approach.
So, the dragons are coming.
Eventually.
Let them come. in their hundreds and their thousands. With the divine blade in our hands, we shall rend their flesh and drown the heretics in their master's blood. Even Nidhogg and his foul brood shall be powerless to resist us. And when we have rid the world of their pestilence, we shall turn our attention to our Asian allies. See that they are suitably rewarded for their invaluable assistance.
If I may, Your Eminence, the Paragons wield powers strange and unknowable. Can we be certain that they will not see through our deception?
We can be certain of naught save the righteousness of our cause. If you would be a true leader of men, you must possess conviction as well as caution. We seek to excise the root of an evil that has blighted us for 1,000 years. The risk is worth the reward.
So they're seeking to destroy the dragons entirely, which the Asians have promised they can do. It's much more likely the Asians are trying to wipe out both dragon resistance and Ishgardian resistance.
And what of Estinian and this Warrior of Light? They have plans of their own.
Leave them to their purpose. We must each play the role we have been given. You and your chosen brothers, most of all.
For the glory of King Thordon.
Okay. Off now would see to one final matter before setting forth. Before we set forth, we must needs inform Tataru of our plans.
Then I shall await you in Sir Rinian's forum. Tell your friend that we may be some time. The road you've chosen is neither short nor easy.
Of that, I need no reminding. Come, Peter, let us head back to Camp Fortemps Manor. To Fortemps Manor. Here on hard times. Yeah, it actually doesn't make sense to have a little dragon fly around us in this place. What do we got? Minimor. I call him Minimor. Okay. The hero seems decked with memory of forgotten promises. The Temple Knights are recruiting. It has long been my dream to join their ranks, and soon I shall make it a reality. I've told myself I'd give anything to be a Temple Knight, but one of their rules gives me pause. We are forbidden from marrying while undergoing training. Hearing this brought to mind a promise I made long ago. Given to flights of fancy and romance, as children are wont to be, I promised a girl that we would marry when we came of age. I was just a boy, and to be honest, I cannot even remember her name, but I worry she may still be waiting for me. All I can recall is she was a ward of House Halanart. I realize my chances are slim, but I would ask that you find her. Tell her she need not wait for me any longer. I could not bear knowing a girl wastes her life waiting for the impossible. Bahimundus seems red hot with anger.
Angry? Of course I'm angry. All I want is to protect my home, and these goddamn knights should sit here and scoff at the ramblings of an old man. Ramblings, my arse! Have you heard what's become of the Falcon's Nest? Most folk there came to Ishgard to keep out of the cold. Now they plan to tear it all away, make a military encampment out of it. A bloody military encampment. What's worse, my son has enlisted to help, little shite. He refuses to listen, and I'm tired of trying to reason with him. Have you seen that slimy backstabbing varlet? You tell him he can come back to his family or not back at all.
All right. We inside the manor?
Yes.
The course is set, Tataru. It may be some time before Pieta and I return to Ishgard.
Yes. He'll be going off and doing dangerous things. Well, you just be careful, all right? Oh, and don't worry about me. I'll be busy listening out for news of our lost friends.
If anyone can find them, it is you, Tataru. Farewell for now.
Oh, before you go, you must put this on off, you know. I made it specially.
What is? Oh, no, I couldn't possibly... Oh, very well.
It looks familiar.
Either 12 fits perfectly, and the quality is actually rather good.
I'm glad you like it. I've been practicing my needlework while I listen to rumors and the like. A good receptionist is always learning new skills.
My thanks, Tataru. Whatever else awaits me upon the road, I shall not fear the cold.
"'Twas the least I could do. Now I must be getting back to the tavern, or I'll never catch up with all the gossip. Best of luck on your journey.
House for Helena as a child. You ask as though there'd be the only one. Sorry to say, my lord has taken in more than I care to count. It'll be no easy task sorting through the lot of them, with so little to go on. Of course, if we're speaking strictly of ladies recently come of age, that may narrow things down, some.
The first that comes to mind is Lady Lenninette down at Thoreau's house. She might be able to steer you in the right direction.
New attire will serve me well in the bitter cold of Korthus. I shall have to thank Tataru properly upon our return.
You've said your farewells, then.
Aye, we are ready to depart. I suggest we begin our search for Lady Iceheart without delay.
Very well. And she will prove an elusive quarry.
You intend to start looking?
Or where do you intend to start looking?
In the absence of any fresh intelligence of the Asaid's movements, I propose we pick up the trail where she was encountered last. The Korthus Western Highlands. Let us speak with Sir Werwald, was it? As commander of Falcon's Nest, it is like he will know of any heretic activity that's been reported in the area.
Well, Master Krollins, what business brings you back to Falcon's Nest? Judging by the company you keep, it could be no trifling matter. The Azure Dragoon I know, of course, but I do not believe I've met this young gentleman.
Alphinor Lavillier, at your service. And you are not mistaken as to the gravity of our mission, Sir Werwald. As I'm sure you're aware, the Observatorium has warned that the Dravanians gather for another assault. We believe that they may yet be a way to avert the coming conflict, but only if we can find the elusive Lady Iceheart. Thus, we have come to Falcon's Nest in hope of acquiring the latest intelligence on the heretic's movements.
I see. And you would be best served by speaking directly to my men.
A patrol is due to return from its sweep of their surrounding lands at any moment. You may also wish to question the knights assigned to pick over the remains of the heretic refuge at Gorgain Mills. It is possible they have unearthed information that could be of use to you. Master Krolinsk knows well the place I speak of, for it is he who first discovered it.
Let us divide our forces, then. I will stay and await the return of the patrol until you, the two of you, visit this refuge. When I have completed my inquiries, I will join you there.
How wise use of our time.
Come, Beata. I'm eager to learn what Sir Relwald's men have found in the Heretic's lair.
Go.
I need to go up a little higher. Can you take...
Oh, inside this little church, huh? Oh, I guess not. Just kidding. Ha ha!
Hey, Jessalo. Yes, I'm Jessalo. He said what? Oh, father's short-sightedness knows no bounds. He fails to see what we stand to preserve by creating this encampment rather than leaving it abandoned to the snows. As the name suggests, Falcon's Nest is well known for its skilled falconers going back generations. While it's true the astrologians can sense horde activity through the stars, it's always been to us to give first alert to their approach. But things changed after the calamity. The weather turned foul, and we have no choice but to seek better shelter. I know how it pained him to abandon Falcon's Nest. It is my home, too. But he has to understand that even if our home has to change, it does not have to change who we are. The proud hawkers of Falcon's Nest will live on, and I will prove it to him. When the day comes for him to return here, the earth beneath him may seem unfamiliar, but our companions gliding proudly through the skies will be as they always have and always will be. This, I swear. There you are. Widow gazing mournfully into the bunch of flowers she's carrying.
Oh, how do you do there, dearie? Not many people have time to talk to someone like me. I wanted to go and visit my husband's grave, but my back is troubling me dreadfully. If you have the time to do a kindness to a weary old woman, it would mean the world to me if you could take these flowers to Gorgain Mills and place them on my husband's grave.
All the currents need getting. Love this music for this mouth. Speaking of adjusting things, Mini Mall can be removed. Definitely not one of my favorites.
I'll only go off the cliff. That's disappointing. Love the music. I really, really do. I haven't properly explored that area yet, so. Alright. Let's see if I can't get there from this left turn route. You know, the left turn route. You heard me. That's something I should be able to do. Get there from the west. Hey, more exploration. Okay, that's what I wanted. Master Krolinsk, our findings, you say? Well, there's something of a tale here. No sooner had we chanced upon a promising-looking shaft of letters that we were... or sheaf of letters. We were ambushed from the shadows by great white beasts.
"'Twould seem the heretics foresaw our coming "'and left behind their pets to discourage further investigation. "'Several of our number were badly wounded. "'And you cannot turn... "'you cannot carry out your duties until the creatures are slain. "'We've not the time to wait for reinforcements. "'Let us deal with these pets ourselves, Peter.'
Right, before we do that, I want to get this thing finished. Flowers of the Grave. Downstairs. Aha! Oh my. King of Warbear, huh? For your help there, Muffino. He kind of did nothing. I heard a frightful growling from below. Kind of more of the beast, I take it. We have defeated Bedgaze. The beasts are slain, then. My thanks, Master Krolinsk. We may return to our duty without fear of mauling. We used to track down Lady Iceheart, is it not so? The records we discovered ere those beasts mauled my comrades appeared to be some matter of correspondence. We had not the luxury of perusing their contents more closely, intent as we were on surviving the onslaught of Fang and Claw, but I'd wager those epistles carry more than a friendly salutations betwixt lonely heretics.
My interrogations of the patrol proved fruitless. Either we divine some clue from these letters, or we wander the snowfields and pray that the gods lend us right to Iceheart's door. It is hardly a choice at all.
Please, no advertising on my stream.
Heretic epistle. It's probably important. Oh, there are two more. Okay. Where are they? Here's another one.
upstairs? Aha! There is one upstairs.
We've collected the heretic epistles. Now we must discuss with people downstairs.
Have you recovered much of the heretic's correspondence?
I have three.
Splendid. Added to the contributions of Master Levellier and Sir Einstein, we've now more than a dozen letters. What do we have done here, then? Every one of these pages is a record of the dealings betwixt the Organi Mills heretics and their fellows at the Arkoff Amphitheater. Their requests for foodstuffs, clothing, all manner of provisions. Isaac's followers must yet inhabit the ruins we had thought had abandoned. Offenor seems intent on traveling to Arkoff Amphitheater. Arkoff Amphitheater, the very place where you witnessed the manifestation of the primal Shiva, was it not? If that is our destination, the journey will be long indeed. The amphitheater lies on the other side of the treacherous tract of snow and ice that cannot swiftly be crossed. We must place our faith in the Aethernet. As you may recall, our dear friend Mabrinda succeeded in recreating the Akamph beacon that had been destroyed by Lady Iceheart. At the same time, it was assumed that the resultant Aethernet would only be temporarily viable. But given that the heretics of Gorgon Mills seems to have been in regular contact with their brethren at the amphitheater, I'd wager it still functions. I suggest we make for the Aetherit within Snowcloak without delay. Correct me if I'm wrong, Estanine, but in the course of mapping the Snowcloak tunnel system, a passage was discovered leading out to the Western Highlands, was it not? Might it be possible for us to reach the Aetherit from this side of the wall? It should. House Durden had posted soldiers at the Western Highlands entrance after the tunnels were cleared. They will not deny us entry. Though.
Excellent. We shall head up that way, then.
Made it visible.
This is really all I wanted in the first place. Excellent. You've explored much. What do we not know? We do not know this top corner. We do not know northern areas. Almost everywhere else is available to us. Available. There we go. Available to us. Let's use the bridge, shall we? It will be easier. It's strange that there's a river leading the bridge, but whatever. I try not to judge. Perhaps that is the That place I just went earlier. That's how we get to the central islands. Right, let's listen to the lady. Already 3 hours from closing time.
Ever so much for that, dearie. I'm sure my husband appreciated it. Well, that, or he's turning in his grave shouting, "Do it yourself, you lazy hag." He used to be a great knight under House Duradet, you know. He was tutor to the house's heir, training him in the ways of combat. I was so proud of him having a job like that. And the heir himself was ever such a bright young lad, a genius, if ever there was one. But one day the poor old boy set out to see the realm and did not come back. We never saw him again. After that, my husband just wasn't the same. He ended up stepping down from his position, cutting his ties with nobility. He became a farmer and started the farm at Gorgraine Mills. I think he just couldn't stand to be reminded of that boy every day near his house to Redair.
Ah, the guests of House Fortemps, accompanied by the Azure Dragoon, no less. I cannot imagine what brought you out this far, but you're welcome to enter the tunnels, if that is your will.
Assuming the Akaf beacon still functions, and we must pray to the 12 it does, we shall arrive at our destination in mere moments. I do not expect to be greeted by the Primal Shiva. We should nevertheless be prepared for frosty reception. The heretics are not like to rejoice at the appearance of uninvited guests, particularly ones with our history. Though.
Go get it.
An impressive structure. I wonder how many ages it's endured.
Perhaps you could ask its occupants. They seem a friendly bunch. Dogs of Ishgard. It's not enough that you banish your beloved saint. Now you will not be satisfied till the ice is slick with the last drops of our blood.
Stay your weapons. We come under the flag of parley. We wish only to speak with your mistress, that we might broker a peace.
You think us fools, boy. Take more than honeyed words to earn our trust. You walk with the Dragon Slayer, and we know all too well what he is capable of.
Oh, my reputation precedes me. They give us little choice, do they?
Come, brothers. May dragon wings bear us to victory. The foulest face a second time.
No, wait, you did not come here to fight.
If there was a man, there are guts to us.
Feel good, I'm ready.
Your god is
Guardian.
Very wild-eyed mage, you can have a bad time.
Duty complete.
Oh, they fight like demons. It is death to remain.
Fall back, brothers. Retreat to the cinders.
I see no sign of Lady Iceheart. Would that we could have questioned one of them.
Would you ask that we do not already know? They make for the cinders, since so must me. So must we, even should an ambush await us. 'Tis certain there'll be more heretics to question.
Cinders, you say? I confess the name is unknown to me. Mayhaps you would want to be so good as to enlighten us, Estinine.
I suspect it's the heretics' way of returning, referring to the dreaming dragon.
an island of sorts found in the midst of the frozen lake of Ashpool. Some 500 years passed. It is told the Azure Dragoon of the age fought a dragon of titanic proportions. After the savage struggle, the mighty creature was weakened to the point of death and forced into a magic slumber by an entire chapter of the Holy Sea's sorcerers. Ere long, a rain of ash and cinders began to fall upon the sleeping serpent's motionless form, covering the creature at length in a shroud of gray. Of course, a thick layer of ice has since formed on top of that, but you may be sure I speak true. A fascinating tale. We should make haste to this ashen isle. Though. The Dreaming Dragon lies far to the west. Before we approach the frozen beast, however, there's another place I would visit first. I'm told the Convictors have set up camp in Twin Pools. Their leader, Jellilo, has information of use to us. Ah, but mayhap you're not familiar with that name either. The Convictors are dragon slayers, after fashion, and I'm willing to wager that they encounter their fair share of heretics. If they are indeed walking into a trap, I would learn all there is to know about Ferno. A sound suggestion. Let us speak with these Convictors, then, and temper our haste with a measure of caution. Victory. Anything, yeah? Well, what do we have here? We're going to join the esteemed ranks of the Convictors, are we? The hard-eyed lad looks promising. You have a frail look about you, boy. I give you 3 days ere the wilds came claim your corpse.
I beg your pardon?
Be not so quick to judge. I've seen this frail youth fail heretics with a flick of his wrist. Oh, who are you to question my... By the Fury! But that armor, that lance, the Azure Dragoon himself raises our camp. Pray forgive my disrespect, sir. I'm Gentle-Lo, leader of the Convictors and fellow Slayer of Dragons. May I ask what winds, fail or foul, carry you to our humble camp?
We're trying to hunt heretics. Maybe we'll talk to them, we hope.
Ah, Lady Iceheart, is it? I know her by reputation. I'm afraid I've caught none of her or her people. That said, my own men can be somewhat lax when it comes to making reports. You may wish to question them yourselves.
Thank you. We shall.
Geta, Estanine, let us make our way through the camp and see what information there is to be had. Bon.
Hmm.
conquest complete. Mount speed has increased. I remember you. How could I forget? You're the lad who was in Azure Dragoon's company. Since you're here anyway, perhaps you might like to try your hand at a spot of hunting before you depart. See for yourself what life is like for us convictors. The Devanian Horde is stronger than you might expect. Unless you've been up at it for years like I have, I think it's prudent to start with something simple, and then work your way up to dragons. I suggest runes. Slay three of those, and then come back here. Consider it a warm-up. Demoniac is shimmering with impatience. Greetings, sir. Reputation precedes you. Once you slay a few primals, word gets round. Seeing as you're so strong and powerful, I was wondering if you might be able to help out with something. I want nothing more than to support the great Sir Amaric, but Ishgardian society revolves around nobility. Those not of noble birth, such as myself, have no power at all. The only way to gain the power of nobility is through truly noble display of courage. There's one simple way to do that. Slay a monstrous ancient dragon. Some feats that cannot be ignored. So, I took up my spear and came to the convictory. Sadly, things have not gone quite as well as I'd hoped. I'm still somewhat new to this, you see. I really don't know much about dragons, especially the larger, rarer ones. All the knights here are competing with each other for honor and glory. None of them will share what they know with each other, for fear of losing any edge that they may have. But you're not a convictor, and they're not competing with you. I doubt they'd be nearly so tight-lipped with you as they are with me and the other knights here. You might be able to learn a thing or two for me about how I might find and kill one of the larger dragons. Alfrino is eager to gather information on the heretics. Surely some of the people who've encountered heretics are out hunting. Pray speak with as many as you can, Gator. Dead care not for justice, but whether would have them see it just the same. Cowards, all of you, have no shame at all. Oh, I beg you. Wait, are you not Master Krogan's honored ward of House Fortens? Praise Halor. Surely you'll consider my request. Know you the Dusk Vigil, westernmost of the Citadel Watchtowers built to watch the Horde's approach. 'Twas lost following the Calamity, another victim of the snows. Within the ruins lies a precious treasure, which must needs be reclaimed. I thought to enlist the services of these so-called dragon slayers, but it seems their courage is not as boundless as they'd have you believe. But you, sir, you're not one to shy away from danger. Am I right? No. Very good indeed. There's a sculpture of the Fury within Dusk Vigil's chapel, an ice rondel set with its helm. I would have you pry it free and deliver it to me. The vigil's not difficult to find. Simply head north toward Banepool till you come to the gates. Knights may bar your passage, but should you explain who you are, they will grant you leave to enter. I know no heretics. Do you honestly expect me to keep track of every Ramanu, Varamon, and Varamir that wanders in and out of camp? Want to know about dragons, do you? Well, you're speaking to the right man. I know stuff about them beasts that even the dragoons haven't heard of. Oh, don't think they'd be telling you for free, though. Tell you what, I'm due to go out on patrol any minute now. It's far too bloody cold for it, if you ask me. I'll put me patrol points in your map here. If you go do my patrol for me, I'll tell you what I know. Are there any heretics in the area? Not the faintest idea. My heretic could pass under my very nose, and he'd be none the wiser. And dragons, my dear fellow. The big ones. Forever do I scan the skies for signs of my prey. I care not for the miserable creatures that scurry upon the ground. Looking for heretics, you say? Why don't you go and bother Pyrenic or someone? I've enough trouble keeping with preening fobs, fed and cleared as it is. There's no business of mine what folk do with themselves out here in the woods.
Summit, something I can help you with, my lord. I'm trying to find heretics. Heretics, is it? Well, I've never seen one myself, but I hate to say I haven't heard a thing or two.
We would be grateful for any information you can share with us. The gods know we've gleaned precious little from talking to the rest of these people.
If it pleases me, Lord, I'm Perlicate, soldier by trade. You're not much of one of them, to be honest. If it weren't for the love of stabbing folk that I took on the spear, you see. No, it was by the order of Sir Gelot's father. Still, as long as they keep paying me wages, I ain't fussy as to what they have me do. Not everyone's as patient as me, though. Plenty of low-born lads who get pressed into service start grumbling before they've seen their second battle. And once they've got to thinking how unfair it all is, it don't take much for the heretics to turn their heads. What I hear, simple promise of freedom tends to do it.
That may explain how Lady Einstein was able to expand her following so quickly.
Sad to say, some mates of mine gobbled down the heretics' tripe and asked for seconds. Told me they were off to the Western Islands to light a signal fire. That's how you let the heretics know you're serious about joining the ranks, apparently. Send up some purple smoke and the bastards will come to you.
Not so. Well then, I minded to start a fire.
Estenine wishes to prepare a signal fire to lure out the heretics. If we're to lure our foes to our position, we must find a means to produce a signal of purple hue. As it so happens, I heard the tale of a trapper who dropped a hide of woolly yak into his campfire. Aside from the terrible stench, the story also described of how the smoke from the smoldering flames was tinged with deep violet. You're a monster hunter of some note, are you not, Pieter? It should prove a trifling task for you to procure a number of hides. We may need to burn some more than one the heretics notice our leak. Master Ulfinol, you and I should gather wood for the fire. Aye, it'll take both of us to find enough dry fuel in this frozen wasteland. Let us meet again with the Dreaming Dragon, with the fruits of our labor. She stares out over the snowdrifts, a grim expression upon her face.
Want to help out, do you? Well, there's plenty that needs doing, and killing besides. I'm sure you've noticed the dragons aren't the only thing we have to contend with out here. Take the polar bears, for example. They come here looking for an easy meal, drawn by the smell of our cook fires, and they raid our stores. Think you could thin their numbers a little. Killing four or so of them should suffice. You'd be compensated for your troubles, of course.
Sure, I'd do these for you.
Rooms.
Goodness, this is terrifying.
Thank you.
That was so freaking intimidating. Howdy, how are you doing, Evac Brandon? Welcome. Should be all of them. Turn in all of that, and then we're going to check this last one up here. Just playing some Heavensward. Thoroughly enjoying this game. Back already, are you? Well, deal's a deal. I'll tell you what I know. I have no idea why, but the corpses of weaker dragons seem to attract the higher-ranking Dravanians. Once you know this, it makes it pretty easy to lay a trap for some of the bigger, nastier dragons out there. Now listen, don't you go telling anyone about this, you hear? Just think about what happens if everyone knew. They're dangerous enough around here to begin with, especially lately. Imagine some low-born young lad with dreams of nobility and nothing to lose. Some guy will come in here and find glory at any cost. Imagine he finds out how to bring the biggest, nastiest monsters of the realm out of hiding. Just keep it to yourself, is what I'm saying. Never be too careful. Right, they'll immediately tell this exact person you don't want to. And the rooms are ready, have you? Well, how'd you find them? Did they put up much of a fight? Good work, Dad. Good work, lad. Clearly the Azure Dragoon didn't travel with mere amateurs. It sounds that those rooms barely put up enough of a fight to be considered proper warm-up. You clearly know what you're doing. If you want to try your hand at hunting down some dragons, speak with me again sometime. He's ready to try your hand at hunting dragons. Those rooms you shared last time may have been easy hunting, but I assure you, dragons are not. Even veteran convictors can find them to be something of a handful sometimes. If you want to try your hand at it yourself, I suggest you start with some Arcanons. They're great feathered scalekin monsters that form part of the Horde's vanguard. You'll find the beasts wandering about in the north near Banepool. Find the 3 Arcanons and put them down without mercy. Consider it a test of your skill, if you will. I've seen you around the convictory, you new recruit. That's any of my business, I suppose. Well, you're back. You better learn anything useful.
Yes, here's how you get dragons to all appear and kill all of your friends.
I see. So I could use the corpses of weaker dragons to attract bigger ones. It seems like I might be able to bag quite a prestigious catch that way.
If you don't die.
I'll start with a small one, kill that, wait for a bigger one to come along, and if I kill that one, an even bigger one should appear. Oh, then I'll kill that one, and so on. In my deepest gratitude, thanks to you, I now know what I must do. Though I must ask for another favor in the future. Please. Look, I'm going to plan to draw out a great ferocious dragon. New recruit has just joined the convictors. I'm delegating the execution of the plan to him. The lad shows a lot of potential, but he's sorely lacking in experience. You, though, my friend, have more experience than anyone in the convictory. I'd be eternally grateful if you could put some of that famous skill to good use and lend the young lad a hand. Soldier's name is Saint-Fremont. Speak to him. He knows all the relevant details, so he can answer any further questions you might have. Then we're going to get all these people killed. Well, you're certainly more than reliable than any lordling I've ever met. They only got eyes for dragons, even though I tell them time and again, no one sees those bears. There's nearly a scrap to eat. So do they listen? I dare say everyone around here could stand a little more like you. Well, I'd say you'll be compensated, and I'm true to my word. I trust you'll consider this fair remuneration for your efforts. Triple grim coffee, something. Lucia's looking for someone to help her keep warm through the cold Carithian nights. Oh, dear. Sorry, I'm taken. Oh, you look troubled, I look troubled, do I? Well, we all have a fair share of troubles out here. You looking to lend a hand? Out there, the cold is constant nemesis. You should always use more yak wool for the creation of our blankets. If you bring me 3 baskets of it, I'll see it's worth your while.
Well, look, listen, Beth.
Saint Romain. Oh, you must be the adventure Dominic said would be assisting me. I made it quite clear I could handle it myself, but the man won't listen. I'm ever so sorry, sir. Mr. Salomon has been having a bad day. He means no disrespect. He'll be more than happy to benefit from your assistance. We ought to start by reviewing the plan. Recently, there have been sightings of a particularly unusual, somewhat diminutive member of the Dravanian horde, a Telehand. It's been observed near the Great Tree to the northeast. If the information you've gathered is correct, we should be able to kill this smaller dragon quite easily and use it as bait to attract a larger one. We shall sally forth to the Great Tree now and find this beast. Once your preparations are in order, rendezvous with us there. We'll be waiting for you. I'm sure this will look great. Alright, let's go off to this one because it's nowhere near anything else. And we'll try to get the rest all together. Spicing up your branding any chance? No, I'm good. Appreciate the offer. The devious little thing, but it's a sight quicker than we'd anticipated. He's gone and hidden himself around here somewhere, without waiting for the ideal moment to strike. A tiny little thing, isn't it? Vengeful Telehand. With him and then play the Telehand. Alright, here we go. Thank you, adventurer. I suppose I owe you an apology for my arrogant tone earlier. I'm still not quite accustomed to life in the Convictory. These Dravanian thralls truly are pitiful things, enslaved by the greater dragons and used as mere tools, cogs in the Dravanian war machine. To be forced to fight against your will, I dare say it's no different to the situation I was once in, two of the High Houses and the Holy Seeds. Discord, send my portfolio here. I think you might have at some point before. I can send it to you. Just a moment. I'll give you the thing. There you go. Like I said, I'm not really interested, but I can give it to you. To be forced to fight against your will, I dare say it's no different to the situation I was once in, tool of the High Houses in the Holy Sea. Any road, we best get this thing back to the camp. We go on ahead and inform Dominiac of our success. All right. Whoops. Yeah. If I'm being attacked, I can't jump off a cliff. It'll kill me. I'll be right back. Yep, I've already gotten one. You've already sent me stuff. This is the second time I've got it from you. Last time it was Evac Creatives Incorporated, so I've already got your stuff. Sending me texts. Okay. Nope, same Twitch. Yeah, Evac Creatives Incorporated on Behance. Nope, haven't changed Twitch ID either. No, you've sent me the stuff already. Thank you. Yeah, I thought I recognized it. Yep, like I said, not interested in upgrading, but you sent me. Yeah, sure. It was a different ID, I guess, or something. I don't know. But yeah, I've got it already. Evac Creatives. Like I said, I thought I had gotten your stuff before. It was a while ago. Yeah. Yeah, it was back July 26th. Had a red hood with a red mask on. White eyes. As I said, not looking to upgrade, so. Already, I say. I think he had no difficulty retrieving the corpse from the Tullian. It all goes according to plan. The upcoming battles could be increasingly dangerous. But if you're anywhere near as powerful as they say you are, if you lend us your assistance, I don't think we'll have any trouble. The time has come to the next step of our plan. Solomon is already making the preparations. He should be above the cliff to the north of the Convictory. Meet up with him there and lend him a hand. Thank you, adventurer. Ah, you're finally here. You might be pleased to know that the information you obtained was indeed correct. Some horrible Dravanian beast, looked like a widget, had come out of nowhere, grabbed the slain Tullian's body from its claws, and scuffled off as quickly as it appeared. Something of a scuffle as it escaped, and it kicked our men about a bit. The creature itself scuttled away under the cliff to the northwest of the Convictory. Please chase it down. We'll see to the wounded. I object to you. We are not wasting any part of this yak.
saving throw. The Arcano. Achiornis. Here. The hostile presence. Oh, that guy. Cool logic. Since we're out here, right? New exploration. Oh, I see. Hey there, Spiteful Knight. Adventures out this way. I was just looking out over Bane Pool. Great battles were fought at this fortress. No matter how brutal, no matter how much blood was spilt, they always waited patiently to swallow all within its tranquil waters. The calamity changed all of that. Lake was frozen over, and slimy, goddamn beast wandered its surface without a shred of respect. And I won't stand for it. I no longer have my old strength, or I'd drive the slimes away myself. Do an old man a favor. Teach some of the old gelati a lesson. Slaughter them, such as I might have done. Another glimpse of the lake as it once was. What's this? A ward of House Fortune pushes you to enter the Dusk Vigil. You are aware the ruins are infested with wild beasts and gods only know what else, are you not? Why, just the other day, one of the convictors claimed to have seen a massive winged beast, not a dragon line, but something altogether different. Far be it from me to deny an esteemed personage the opportunity to kill himself in new and exciting ways. Pray, go on ahead. Dusk Vigil is now accessible. Gelato. see more gelatos, then go ahead and take care of this. Watch this. Anything, your actions speak loud enough. You have my thanks. Seems some adventurers are worth their salt after all. Ah, now I can finally remember this place as it once was. The battles we fought, friendships we forged all atop the lake's still waters. Should be able to just accept that one thing. Well, let's go off this way, since this one's way up, nowhere near anything else. Seem that collecting firewood is a new experience for Master Orphanol. He must have had privileged upbringing. Him. Have you the hides we need? Use yak hides.
Ah, I should have known it would be you. Word reached me of a struggle with a small but well-armed band of trespassers. Forgive my comrades their hostility. Few come here uninvited, and fewer still with good intent. Now, tell me why you are here.
I wish to parley. I wish to speak with you.
So, you seek to stem the Dravanian tide with talk? A romantic notion. If you but knew the truth, the spark which lit the flames of this animosity, you would understand the futility of your quest. Shall I relate it to you? The sordid history my gift has shown me, that which the Holy See has taken such pains to suppress?
Yes, yes, tell us. Let us find common ground.
'Twas more than a millennium past when an Elizan tribe first sought to claim the lands of Kirthas as its home. Unfortunately for them, Kirthas was already home to dragonkind, and they were not inclined to make way for the invaders. Thus did a bloody war begin, a war which might well have rumbled on until one or the other side was exterminated, had it not been for the resolve of a single woman. That woman's name was Shiva.
Ah, yes, the heretic.
While those around her fought and died, she attempted to parley with the dragons, and in so doing discovered them to be possessed of profound intelligence and reason. The great worm, Hraesvelgar, in particular, so enchanted Shiva that she found herself growing to love the creature, whom her people considered a monster.
In the eyes of a near-immortal dragon, however, the fleeting life of an Elizan is as that of a freshly cut rose. Scarce has the flower bloomed before it begins to fade and wither. Such melancholy musings plagued Race Vulgar, who had found in Shiva an unexpected and beloved soulmate. He knew that all too soon, death would snatch her away from him.
Indeed.
Unable to bear the thought of their separation, the maid bid the worm consume her, that their spirits might be entwined for eternity. Though loath to perform the deed, Hraesfelga ultimately gave in to her plea, and soon thereafter the tale of their ill-fated love spread throughout the two warring factions. No more could they raise blade or claw against one another, knowing that the souls of their kin were so inextricably bound. In the days that followed, man and dragon learned to live in harmony, and together built a nation unlike any the world had ever known. For 200 years did this blissful age of peace continue, as it would to this day, had vilest envy not stirred in the hearts of the Elizan. It is said that worms owe their longevity to the boundless reserves of vitality found within their eyes. And 'twas in this belief that a traitorous band of knights deceived their allies of some 2 centuries, and took by force that which they coveted.
The eyes of the dragon. We've talked about this.
Nidhogg, he who now stands poised to unleash his wormlings upon Ishgard, was the great dragon who lost an eye to Elizan treachery. And until he prizes it from the hands of the traitor's progeny, no amount of conciliatory words will stay his fury.
Hey, guess who we brought? The guy with the dragon eye.
You are wrong, Lady Iceheart. Lest you misunderstand, I do not doubt your vision of the past. 'Tis true that Nidhogg greatly desired to reclaim the eye. Indeed, it was for that very reason that I kept it with me as I roamed the land, attempting to draw him away from the city.
Good gods!
Yep.
Until recently, Nidhogg seemed unable to resist its allure and pursued me relentlessly. Needless to say, that is no longer the case. Now, it would seem, he has fixed his attention on Ishgard itself, though he knows full well the Eye does not reside there.
Wishes for revenge.
You believe he targets the capital for another reason?
Vengeance.
I believe reason has all but left him. Through the Eye, I feel much of what Nidhogg feels. And the dragon's thirst for vengeance will not be quenched by aught less than a sea of blood.
That's a problem.
If Nidhogg is indeed lost to reason, might we not seek an audience with Hraesvelgr instead?
That would make sense.
He has thus far shown no inclination to aid in the invasion of Ishgard, and may yet welcome our efforts to broker a peace.
One would hope.
You still believe that a peaceable solution can be found? Very well. I will take you to him. Our road will lead us to Dravania, the homeland of dragonkind. There we shall ascend unto the clouds, where Hraesvelgr resides.
This is a cool story. Uh-oh. We've got summer. Connected with the ice.
Interesting.
Is autumn miss, my friend?
I was cut off from all of crystals, and now I'm back with ice. It's weird.
I sense the many battles are beginning to take their toll. Rest a while. And should you lose sight of us, Dravania lies beyond the mountains to the west.
Tell me, Midgardsummer.
Curious. The vestiges of thy mistress's blessing are not as faint as once they were. Thy will to succeed grants thee unusual fortitude. But will it be enough?
We're 1/6 of the way through the story, I guess, of Heaven's Word. Better understanding of Aria's movements of winds. With the Chocobo's roam, Lady Iceheart stands ready to lead you and your companions into Dravania.
You are Pieta, yes? Pray address me as Isael, if you wish. 'Tis passing strange, is it not, that fate should bring us together, thus? Never did I think to walk aside the Warrior of Light. But history is full of such unexpected alliances. Shall we make our way into Dravania, then? The chill of the western highlands is unrelenting, and I would sooner be under the sheltering canopy of the Chocobo Forest. Chocobo Forest! All right. Need that wool if you're willing to procure it.
I have wool. Here you are.
Some of the highest quality wool I've ever seen, I must say. You've gone above and beyond what I asked of you. You have my deepest thanks. The night's a bitterly cold these days, but the blankets made from this wool will do much to keep our people warm. He keeps looking worriedly out toward the east. Whatever could be taking him so long? It oughtn't take this much time just to deliver a message. I sent the man out on a mission quite some time ago. He should have been back hours ago, but there's still no sign of him. He was on Chocoback, so he should have returned by now. You do me a favor of heading out toward River's Meet and seeing if you can find him. Meow. How'd you find those Arcanoids? They may not be smart, but they certainly put up a good fight, would you not say?
Yes, they took care of you.
It's uneasy. Not all of us had the opportunity to fight alongside the Azure Dragoon to see firsthand how best these mighty beasts might be brought down. Many Ishgardians think we nobles of the Convictory are simply out here foppery of whim. Yeah, they scarcely understand the risks about defending Ishgard from the Horde. But I feel perhaps that you understand. If ever you decide you want to join the Convictors, you need but say the word. The man will not stop moaning about his leg. Oh, my leg. The last dragon made a mess of it. Had it happened to anyone else, I dare say, it made a meal of. Fortunately, made of stone stuff, and got away with no more than a flesh wound to show for it. I'm keen to get back out there and hunt that bastard down, but I shan't be going anywhere till this leg heals up. Say, do you think you could fetch something for me? The waters of Dragonspit are said to have healing properties, and I have some of that. I'll be back on my feet in no time. Take this bottle, and fill it with water from that spring, will you not?
Yes, dragon spit. Nothing about that sounds unappetizing.
can't quite fly yet. Aether currents. How close am I? Oh man, I'm one current away from being able to fly.
It dispatched Lucinae to find me. Well, I finished my mission. Can't go back to the camp just yet. I'm still searching for Amberbeak, my dear Chocobo. I was attacked by a yeti and thrown to the ground. Just when I thought the great beast would tear me to shreds, Amberbeak distracted the thing and drew it away. He damn well saved my life. I fear the monster will catch him. I have to save him. You'll find him for me. I'd like to join you in the search, but I would only slow you down in my present condition. Thank you. I shall head back to the Victory now, but please, please bring Amberbeak back to me.
Me and my chocobo will find your beak.
Smokey completed the adventure. Good job, Smokey. That's a good key. Good job. So, I think I'm gonna need a fly to take care of that. You can't just yet. So. again. I feel like I should be able to get out of this hole. Giving up on that one until I can fly. Thank you. I didn't see the fight itself, but having seen you in combat before, I think I have a good idea of how it turned out. We'll collect the body and put it somewhere near the Dravanians can see it. These Dravanians sure are a curious bunch. Whatever are they trying to achieve by gathering the corpses of the weaker thralls? What are they using the bodies for? They say the smarter animals out there have feelings. Perhaps the Dravanians are simply showing respect for their fallen comrades. Perhaps they can't stand to see their friends' bodies torn apart by the elements. Perhaps I just want to see them and let them rest in peace. You have some peculiar ideas sometimes. You really think these monsters have feelings? They respect one another? No, they're no different from us. The strong use the weakest tools. That's not a shred of respect to be seen. Your entire hypothesis is... I'm sorry, I'm ranting. We'll go out and collect the dead Wadget. You report back to Dominic, and let him know that things are proceeding according to plan.
already. The information you gathered turned out to be accurate. Were you able to attract a larger dragon?
Well, sort of.
Good, good. Seems the next step in my plan has unfolded quite nicely. If things continue on like this, you should be able to bag quite an impressive catch before long. Wants help with the next stage of his plan. I'm just about to carry out the next step of my plan. Sergeant Moll has finished his preparations. So, he should be waiting for you out on the cliff to the north. If all goes well, we'll attract an even larger beast than before, so be on your guard. That's a advanced dragon slayer. You see the Avis just now, snatched up the largest corpse and made its escape. Our men are chasing the thing down as we speak. The bait was set under the cliff northwest of the Convictoria, and we should head there first, then follow the trail from there. Be on your guard. Avis are renowned for their cunning. Seems the Avis has fled to the northwest, into Dragonspit. We'll block the exits and corner it. You get in there and help finish it off.
Dragonspit, yes. Wonderful place. I think your name is Fisher. This dragon is full of spit, yes?
Dragonspeed Spring.
Some speed water from Dragonspeed. And get some exploration fees. Excellent, that's what I wanted.
Play it.
Yes, they took care of it.
Marvelous. Good work indeed. Very good work indeed. Ah, but did you notice anything about the Avis? Just got to thinking while you were slaying it. Is it true? What did it say? Did it speak? It said the Avis is what had become of men, heretics who drink dragon blood. What could make a man? Master Celebrimbor? Yes, yes, good work, Peter. We will collect the body of the beast. You should return to Dominique and report our success. Dominique. I'm back already. Things are proceeding swimmingly, it seems. Why do you look somehow troubled? What happened?
He killed and told that it was person. Whatever.
I suppose it's not surprising he might say something like that.
Stormont's born into nobility.
He knows all too well the pain of losing honor and status. Well, that's all in the past now, and we hope this experience can steel his resolve. I seem worried about some turmoil. It's good to see you. The corpse of the Avis you slew is being put in a position right now to attract a great dragon for us to slay. How am I concerned about Sir Trenomong? He seems even more morose than his normal grim self. I want to help him, but perhaps because I'm his commanding officer, he really does not want to talk to me about it. You think he might be able to talk to him for me? Two of you have been through quite a few battles together now. He might be more inclined to share his troubles with you. He's off to the north of the camp. Preparations for the next step of the plan should all be finished by now. We'll just be waiting for you there. Do you have that spring water? You need to get back out there. I'm sick of seeing this dragon strut about without a care in the realm.
It's dragon spit for you.
Good, good. Not a moment too soon. A few of these dragons are starting to forget the taste of Ishgardian steel. After a few applications of this, I'll be ready to get back out there and give them a sharp reminder. They say this stuff is better than any potion. Just as well, given how meager our supplies have been getting lately. All right, I'm running out of space. Friend. As you can see, the Avis's body has been laid out in plain sight, and none of the Horde have shown any interest in the thing.
Yes, I was supposed to talk to you.
Me? Something I want to talk about? No, not really. Spending all day keeping vigil over Giovannian corpses lends one to thinking about these creatures more than one might expect. All things considered, this Avis was quite a high-ranking creature of the Horde. I have no doubt that whatever comes to collect its body will be quite a mighty dragon indeed. They're wise, intelligent creatures. They won't be tricked easily. I've taken a great deal of care with the preparations, but still no dragon comes. I think you might take a look at the Avis for me. Just make sure there's nothing out of the ordinary. Something I might have missed. Of course. You don't see anything. Nothing out of the ordinary. Well, if it looks good to you, then I'm satisfied. It must just be a matter of time. It's all the same to you. Would you mind waiting with us till the dragon shows itself? Of course. It's a hostile presence. Oh, a vengeful river. Stories about them. An ancient creature that once soared effortlessly through the crowds. They must go their whole lives without ever seeing one of these legendary beasts. I should take a minute to check its body before we take it back to camp. You go back to the Victory and report to Dominique. But I'll handle getting the dragon's bodies back to their camp. Of course.
certainly took longer than I expected. Did the plan work? Tell me everything that happened.
They showed up and they immediately killed it.
A wyvern? You slew a wyvern? I have no words to express my gratitude. Thank you for your help. Sir Tremont shall be back by now. Could you do me one more favor and make sure he's made it here safely? Sir Tremont, I have reported back to Dolomek already. I got back just moments ago. I'm just about to get started examining this beast. Would you be so kind as to lend a hand? You may well start with the legs, as good as places, Lenny.
Here's the third leg. It looks tasty.
Find a Tullihan scale and a Wadgett scale and a ribbon claws. Finished already? Did you find anything interesting?
Your skills.
A scale from the Tullihan and one from the Wadgett. Both in the claws of the wyvern. This mighty creature carried away their bodies and kept mementos of memory of its fallen comrades. These creatures know each other, recognize each other, mourn for each other. Even Dravanians should show such concern for each other. Depending on my status and nobility, I led such an easy life that when my house fell, when I was betrayed by those I trusted, I blamed everyone else around me. In retrospect, I should have blamed myself. It was my own fault that I was abandoned by both those I served and those who served me. Sir Tremont, why do you think I'm still here serving you? Your house may well have been disgraced, but I serve you, not your house. I fully intend to remain your loyal servant to the end. I think, if anything, you're too loyal. But I still greatly appreciate it. I came here looking for a place to die. Perhaps now is as good a time as any to let the old bitter me die and let go of all that hatred. From now on, I want to live. Not for social status or nobility, but to protect those close to me. To protect my friends, to protect the people of Ishgard. I shall travel to my family's graves and swear an oath to protect those I care about. I've not yet been to their graves. I've been too ashamed to show my face. But if even the Dravanians can mourn their dead properly, then I think I should find it within myself to do the same. Though. You seem pleased with yourself. Something happened with Sir Tremont?
Yes.
I see. Thank you. I too owe you my thanks. Thank you not just for the inspiration you provided Sir Tremont, but for the invaluable assistance you've provided in helping my plan come to fruition. If things continue to progress this way, we may catch ourselves a dragon yet still greater than this wyvern. A great accomplishment like that would serve Emmerich's cause well. And I appreciate it. Young though he may be, Sir Tremont has achieved truly courageous feats of combat and has opened a world of opportunity for himself. When other young men hear of his exploits, they'll be ready, eager to rally to Amric's cause and fight under his banner. If anything, I'd like nothing more than to recruit you, but somehow I get the feeling you're not of the kind to settle down in one place, much less somewhere as remote and isolated as the Convictory. Still, I hope that you'll continue to lend us your strength from time to time. Here's my feeling. Into the Dusk Vigil. Alright. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna hang out in here, use the restroom, and then we'll get started on Dusk Vigil and some of these other missions.
All right. Let me get some water. I'll be right back.
Let us do Dusk Vigil then. Thank for lack of clarity.
Yeah.
Well then. Thank you.
Hey, I got a commendation. Awesome. Thanks, guys. It's quite dark. Do you have it, Master Kolinsk?
It is Ice Wandle.
Yes, there's no mistaking it. At last, it's ours once more. My parents presented this sapphire to me on my wedding day, as my wife and I presented it to Ymerlik on his. One day they'll do the same for their son. But for that disgrace of an Inquisitor, suspicion of heresy that ought rot. He knew what he wanted from the start. But the time I secured her release, they'd interrogated her for days. Was a shadow of her former self. For the final insult, the final twisting of the knife, was when my son took command of the Dusk Vigil and found the Ice Rondel to be the centerpiece of a newly commissioned sculpture of the Fury. We couldn't prove it was the self-same one that had vanished, but no, he knew. No more, it's back with the family where it belongs. It's admittedly a hollow comfort, yet in my waning years I must accept what little I can find. Better sleeping of the lands. With this Western Highlands, after Aether Current attunement is now complete. We can now fly. Fly, my pretties. Trying to play a game, guys. Trying to stream something. Stop sending me texts. Yes, I know. I have an appointment in 2 hours. Root canal! Good times will be had by all. Canceled. Oh, really? Says Amberbeak, but upon closer inspection, it's obvious the poor bird has been brutally eviscerated. You take a feather from the fallen chocobo. Did you find him? Did you find Amberbeak?
Here is the chocobo bird feather. He's not doing so good.
This feather. Amberbeak. No. No, he fought violently with me there. For many years. Tell me, was it quick?
Almost like it, though.
I see. Well, thank you for this feather. At least I'll always have something to remember him by. Thank you.
Lots of faded manuscripts. No way to use them. Oh well.
Broken body of Amberbeak. Extract material from this world.
Level 52 disciple of hand to meld this material.
Well, not at the moment. Let us go to the Vanian Forelands and see if there is crystal there. If so, we can attune and then possibly move on to other missions.
Beyond Abalathia's spine, the great mountain range that spans the continent of Aldenard from east to west. Into the deepening shadows of Som Arl, where lies the ancient home of dragonkind.
Nice crystal.
To a land where the soil slithers and the sky seethes with sinuous shapes, they came.
Okay, I'm looking for crystal.
We now stand on the threshold of Dravania. The path of Sol and I will take us far to the west, beyond the embrace of the forest branches. It'll be a long and demanding journey. Might I suggest we take our rest at the village up ahead and see that we're properly provisioned? There's a village here? I thought these lands are the sole domain of dragonkind. Why would anyone choose to live in so perilous a place? The wild chocobos, tail feathers, were built by hunters who made their living capturing and selling the beasts. Their leader, Marshasham, is an acquaintance of mine. Being a generous, gregarious sort, they no doubt welcome our arrival. He will also possess more recent knowledge of the road that we travel, or the road that we seek to travel. I trust there'll be no objection.
Only this ceaseless chatter. If we're to meet this acquaintance of yours, let us do it before Ishgard burns.
Hey, there's a crystal. Hey, more exploration. And there's a crystal.
Whoops.
Give us a tune. to the Aetherid. We'll meet with Eshiva. I've spoken with a handful of locals. A strange woman has been witnessed coming and going with some regularity. I'm reasonably confident it is Alakwa, and I shall try to gather more information for good measure. Something occurs to me, Pieter. If Alakwa is indeed responsible for creating the taint, she'll not take kindly to us purifying it. It may well come to a confrontation. Pray, use this time to further hone your powers, for we shall have need of them ere long. White mage. A size? Unexpected damage. Let's say 400 to all nearby enemies. Oh. Let's talk to Eshiva again. Eshiva's eager to share new information about Alakwa. Good tidings, Pieter. I've acquired definite information on Alakwa. As before, the stench of death gave her away. A hunter she chanced to walk near couldn't help but notice the smell. When she realized that she was being observed, she quickly turned her steps west toward dragon territory. The hunter shouted a warning, but she continued on heedless. In light of her inclinations, I dare say she had business there. There's an area called Avoni fallen to the west. Let us head in that direction and try to pick up Alakwa's trail. Well, turn my eye and call me Leatherface. We have visitors. Oh ho, it ain't the lovely Ysel. It's been too long, girl. That it has, Master Champ, that it has. My companions are on a pilgrimage to Somai. Might we stay in Telfeld for a while and prepare for the next leg of our journey? Of course, of course.
Stay as long as you like. In fact, I wouldn't suggest leaving the forest at all. The dragon's been absolutely bleeding murderous of late. Forgive me, sir, but I'm not sure I understand. Do the dragons not bother you here in the forest? Bother us? You say I'll not explain things to you, boy. You've seen them towering cone trees of bold about, have you? If you are flying above the canopy, you'd barely be able to see the ground. And as you'd expect, the local wildlife's canny enough to stay hidden beneath the leaves, which is where the dragons do their hunting elsewhere. And we can do ours in peace. I say thank you for the explanation. You're welcome. Now, it won't do to stop the sale here, but dragons ain't the only things you'll need to keep an eye out for, especially if you're set on heading west. Quest complete. Worse than dragons. Might as well give you fair warning about what awaits the west. I dare say you're wondering what could possibly be worse than dragons, yeah? Well, I'll tell you. The bloody Nath. Hey, what you would get if you crossed an antling with a Megala crab and thought the thing had to walk on two legs. They never used to stray far from their hives out of fear for the dragons, but we've gotten a lot more aggressive of late, sending out war parties from Molms in all directions. They've even taken to harassing the Dravanians in their own lairs, if you can believe it. And when they venture into the forest, which is more and more, by the way, they certainly aren't afraid to come after my lot. I can only imagine how much worse it'd be closer to Nathom territory. I'm looking for a reliable pair of feet. I see you've been making the rounds lately and getting to know the hunters in these parts. Well, how'd you like to help a real hunter? I'm overseeing the three camps to the east. The lazy sods ain't sent me a report for over a fortnight, and I'm too bleeding busy to be playing messenger. You look right fierce enough to get the information out of them. It's a simple job, earn you some coin, can't rightly say no to that. And if that tickles your fancy, then you'll need to talk to the leaders of each camp. Dustin Hall, Colonel, Adam Bear. Hear what they have to say and get back to me when you're done. It would seem that much has changed, Edravania. The Nath are not wont to cause such strife when I came back. The Nath were not wont to cause such strife when I lived there. You lived here? In Edravania? Aye, 'twas the time following the calamity. My family was dead, my home was gone, and I had fled for the bitter cold into these lands. I knew not the paths of the forest then, and wandered out from under the protection of its boughs. That was when I chanced upon Hrasfalga. He descended from his mountain lair to hunt for food. My exhausted mind could not contend with the sight of this majestic worm, nor the vision of his past, his presence visited upon me. Thankfully, Marshalcom found my unconscious form at the edge of the trees, and nursed me back to health, and in Telfeth I remained for some time. Hence your familiarity with the locals. But I interrupted you. You were saying the Nath are much more peaceful people. Well, peaceful would not be the most fitting description. They are a fiercely territorial tribe, and any who would intrude upon their domain are attacked without hesitation or quarter. Outside the borders of their homeland, however, they are rarely hostile. Indeed, we were ever able to trade with them on occasion.
They've changed, then. What's up, Diggs BTW? What of it? We are not the time to creep through the underbrush or some roundabout route. I say we make straight for Soma A and crush the unruly insect we meet underfoot.
A more direct path it is, then. Let us first follow the trail west out of the forest and make for the statue of the Stained One. From there, we should have a fair view of the road that leads to Soma A, shall we?
Got about 40 minutes of 40 minutes of streaming. I will have to stop today at lunch because I got a root canal. Exciting stuff coming today. Big Rom. Rom seems to have chocobos on his mind.
Chocobo hunting isn't as easy as it looks. These birds are too clever by half. I've designed some new traps though. I've set up around Telfeather a few days ago. Won't be about time to check them. Think you could do that for me? There are two of them. One upstream the Holum River, and one out the east of Tailfeather. All you really need to do is head out there and see if they've caught anything. We'll think.
after Ironheart. Let me get on, call me a chocobo. That's Millim sightseeing log you've got there.
Yes.
Ahem, forgive me. I got carried away for a moment. I'm Kester Ironheart, cousin to Millith, and an explorer of sorts, like most of my extended family. When I last spoke with Millith, she told me of an adventure of the keen case of wanderlust, the adventure that I now know to be you. What say you lend me your log for a moment? Don't worry, I won't eat it or anything.
Yeah, sure, I'll never use it anyway.
There, and yes, there. That should do it, I reckon. It's no secret Ishgard is home to some of the most remarkable sights in our realm. Mind you, I've not seen them all myself. I certainly know where they might be found. And now so do you, thanks to the notes and rumors I've set to jot down in your sightseeing log. Yet scores of stunning vistas are just waiting to be discovered. Your legs will not carry you to all of them, though. Should you find a particular spot out of reach, you may consider taking the skies atop a black-feathered bird. Oh, if I say more, I'll be robbing you of the joy of discovering these spectacular views for yourself. Godspeed, my fellow explorer. May this moment mark the beginning of a tour of wonder. Sightseeing log explained. Expanded. And word entries have been added to your sightseeing log. You must be level 50 or above to record heavenward vistas. Travel to the location indicated and fulfill the necessary conditions, and you'll complete the entry for that vista, earning experience points in the process. Use your wits and the notes provided by Kester to identify these stunning sights and the proper way to appreciate them. And see Ishgard as only the greatest explorers have seen her. Yep, we'll never do that again. Time to attune. This is my new home. Leopard. Leopard is looking for someone to watch over a novice hunter. Well, if it isn't the famed Pieter everyone goes on about, word travels fast in a camp this small. Say, could you lend me your ear for a bit? Thanks for keeping this lonely hunter company. Anyway, since you're new around here, I thought you might want to know about this place and its denizens. You see, the hunters of Tailfeather make their way by catching the wild chocobos wandering around these forests and selling them to the renowned Ishgardian trainers. You might think us hunters have an easy end of the deal, but you'd change your mind quick enough the first time a dragon breathes down your neck. Add to that all the other hungry beasts looking for an easy meal, and you'll be right to doubt the sanity of this whole camp. That's why most hunters in the Dravanian Forelands are either them that are just trying to escape the pitiful lives back home, or them that are crazy enough to get enjoyment from risking their necks each day. Of course, you can't forget that those that are just here for a quick bucketful of gill, chasing the golden chocobo, so to speak. The promise of riches brings new blood from all over Eorzea. Isn't that right, Kitana?
You've got that right. I'm here to bag myself the biggest chocobo Eorzea's ever seen.
Thing is, chocobo hunting's generally done in pairs, and Kitana here, having never trapped an animal herself, is in need of a partner. I know you've got some experience hunting all manner of beasts, so I'm asking you to help her out till I find someone more suitable. Well, I can't thank you enough, Pieter. Katona's got some ideas on her first hunt. Speak to her, and she'll tell you all about them.
Quest accepted.
Finally, a partner. Now we can be real hunters. Let's not keep those birds waiting. This hunt will be simple. All we have to do is lure a chocobo out there, these Gishul Greens. There's only one problem. Wild chocobos have a keen sense of smell and won't come near a trap if they catch even a whiff of a hunter scent. But fret not, for I have a plan. Just the other day, I came across some mushrooms that reek. I can still smell. If we use them to hide our scent, these chocobos will be none the wiser. I'll take care of arranging the Gishul Greens for the trap, and I need my partner, that's you, to go and pick that pungent fungus for me. It seems the hunters call the mushroom Chandler's Wick, and about 5 or so should do the trick. Just head out east of Tailfeather for a bit, and use your nose to guide you the rest of the way. Yes, sure, one more. Well, met traveler, might I interest you in a chocobo porter? Oh, don't tell me. You don't give a crap about me.
That is correct, sir.
All right. Better, please, huh? Aha! Chocobo snare. some rather large place. With chokeable snare. Trap was not strong, and neither do you see any bait. What is first trap? Chokeable took out the bait. They are quite smart creatures. Oh, come on. Ah. What's that meal nuffle? I think they're going well enough. Been running into a bit of trouble with these giant bugs of the woods, huh? What's this first hunter? Let's try to get the others then. Over here. How do I get up there? Ugh. The 20th week. That's one. That's two. Let's see here. Any more? I don't see any. That's the around corner. Several more. Ugh. Up here. Am I supposed to get up here? Till I stop. Here's the last one. Alright. If we can't keep each other, some battle to do. Nothing out of the ordinary here. Just one bird that won't shut up. Haven't been able to catch a wink for all the bloody screeching. You stick them on too? Thank you, they're done. Snicker snack. So look away. Had ourselves a bit of an incident the other day. Some fiend came stomping out of the tree line and gobbled up one of my fresh caught birds. What a damn thing we do about it. If we're going to keep watch in this area, we need to keep some extra hands. You tell the chief that.
Right, let's go this way. If we can head this way, no exploration. This second chocobo snail is supposed to fit.
Much more when you use any bait.
First thing, so the chocobos are finding ways to eat the bait without getting trapped.
They are smart birds, we've been told this. Proceeding to where we are going without letting anyone stand in our way. What do you think you forgot now? I found the neighbors. Destination. What have we found here?
Should we chance to meet Marsha Comp again, remind him me to thank him. Had not warned us to expect Nath, I doubt we would be standing here. Amidst ruins I would tentatively describe as Ishgardian, the style, if not quite identical, betrays a definite resemblance. You have a scholar's eye, Master Offenor. This structure is, in fact, over 1,000 years old. It's a remnant of an age when our ancestors and dragonkind lived together in peace.
Claim this is evidence of a harmonious past. I was taught these buildings were constructed by heretics to honor your Dravanian masters. This rubble inspires not so much awe in me.
Stubborn fool. How desperately you cling to the false teachings of your beloved Holy See. Enough, both of you. You threaten the success of our mission with this incessant squabbling. Pieta, pray reason with these two.
The truth of the past will be revealed.
Right, lest you forget, our goal is to prevent war, which will claim the lives of Dravanians and Ishgardians alike. If we were to accomplish this, you must learn to tolerate each other's presence. Trust in Pieta's gift. In time, the secrets of history will be brought to light. Let that be enough, Estelle.
You would have me keep my counsel.
You'd have me keep my counsel until Pieta's visions confirm the truth. Very well. But bait me not. Our meeting with Hresvelga will likely provide the catalyst Pieta's gift requires, as did mine. Let us press on.
Yazale wishes to survey the approach to the distant towers. Despite the three great towers to the west, Ishgardians know them as the Ankh's Trine. The place serves as a roost for his Ralga's lesser kindred. If we were to reach the peak of Somiai, then we must first beseech these dragons to open the way. But do not be disheartened. The one who leads them is a friend. Rather more concerned to me is the disposition of the Nath. Let us survey the approach to the towers and see if the path is clear.
Let's see if we can take care of this mission while we are here. Level 59, I'm not particularly scared. whatever we find out here. Most especially in invasion. We discovered the location.
The road ahead is teeming with Nath soldiers. Algernon did not exaggerate, then. These beastmen have grown brazen, indeed, if they would threaten the dragon so openly. Do they intend to assault the lair itself? I pray they do not. Mighty though my Dravenian friends are, they are yet vulnerable to Nath's muskets. There's no route save the one before us. Should the beastmen offer battle, we have no choice but to accept. No signs of Alakwa, and the area beyond is fraught with danger. Not even hunters dare bathe Jirin. I would sooner not wander these parts without some guarantee Alakwa is near, but we cannot afford to delay, lest she elude us completely. Let us split up and search. If you would focus on the area to the north, I shall follow the highlighted west. The high road west. Oh, and do keep an eye out for the taint. If Alakwa is here, it is like to have manifested.
Shrine.
It's got a location.
Hostile presence. Oh, dang it. Stop it. Nope.
Very similar to something we met in, Final Fantasy XII.
I take no pleasure in killing the Nath. It was to avoid bloodshed I agreed to join you on this journey. Well, it cannot be helped. We must proceed into the courtyard together, but leave the task of hailing its occupants to me. And keep your lance at your back, Dragoon.
On the word of the Warrior of Light, I shall start no fight, only finish it.
You truly are beyond salvation. Come then.
Tis thee, little one.
From above, I did mistake thee for a nath. Tis well I chanced to look again, or thou wouldst now be ash.
Dear Vidofnir, how I have missed you. Would that I had come sooner, and not out of dire necessity.
Thou art troubled. Speak that I might know thy plight.
It's going to stop the war.
Thou wouldst have father admonish his brood brother.
I would end this war without further bloodshed.
How am I to believe thee, little one, when thine own companion beareth Nidhogg's stolen eye?
Have care, dragon, or I shall gouge out one of yours.
Oh yeah, this is going awesome.
You forget yourself, sir. We are here on a mission of peace.
My sires will forbiddeth me from inviting discord to our home. 'Tis for this reason and no other that thou still drawest breath, knight.
Vidofnir, please. We must be allowed to convey our intentions to Rhys Felgar in person, with words of our own choosing. Grant us this favor, and open the way to Som Al.
Not Al, not I.
Thou hast ever been welcome, little one. But I cannot grant thy wish. I am bound to remain here, and protect my kin from the Nath's god.
The Nath have summoned a primal.
That's not good.
Pray excuse my forwardness, but if we were to eliminate the threat to your territory, would you consent to Lady Izal's request?
Ha! Dost thou imagine thyself equal to the task? To succeed where dragons have failed?
They have my ways.
'Tis beyond thee, mortal. But thou art welcome to try, nonetheless. Only know that idle promises shall avail thee naught.
It would seem we have no choice but to make good on Alfino's offer. Why must our every bid for peace breed yet more war?
Sale seems preoccupied with thoughts of the Nath and their primal. The Nath have summoned their god, and thus is the mystery of their newfound belligerence laid to rest. Are you not glad, Lady Iceheart? I thought you'd applaud them for summoning a primal to further their own ends. After all, you did. I did not reach out to St. Shiva to further my own ends. I desired her strength only to forge anew a peace between man and dragon. Fool, I am to speak of peace to you, bloodthirsty savage who murders without thought of compunction. Enough. Enough, I say. If the Nath have truly wrought forth their deity from the Aether, we must face it together, or watch our hopes fall apart. All now rests upon their primal's defeat. But ere we think of confronting it, we must first study its origins. What is the nature of this god? What manner of faith sustains its existence? I apologize, you're right, of course. Let us return to Tailfeather and consult with Marshad. He knows more about the Nath and their culture than theirs.
Before that, though, I want to attune to this crystal. In fact, that would be a good stopping point for today.
All right. Well, I will be back tomorrow And that'll be my last day of fall break. So, thanks so much for watching. Hope you have a wonderful day.